For less than the average price of a new car, you can get two new Hyundai Excels. They're both dependable, have front-wheel drive, room for five, and more standard features than any cars in their class. The only problem is getting them home. Hyundai, the cars that make sense.
That car commercial said in 30 seconds what Nigel Lawson only managed to put across after 6 years at the Treasury. There are penalties to be paid for trying to enjoy too much of a good thing. It's a message long understood by every friend of the earth, but since the stock market crash made BMW buying yuppies unfashionable, advertisers have been turning non-consumption into a trend. The green bandwagon is rolling, and all over the world, advertisers are consuming large amounts of the world's finite resources to encourage us to use less of them. Surely some mistake there. Anyway, Spanish miners had to dig for an extra ton of coal to generate the electricity consumed in this commercial.
If you don't use appliances at home when you don't need to, why switch on the television if you're not going to watch it? Learn to use your television. Check the program guide.
In Italy, they're planning a very efficient way of cutting down TV consumption. They want to switch off transmissions altogether on Saturday mornings, so kids can find out what life was like before television took over. American parents have long known how to stop their kids watching rubbish. In the 50s, they had already switched on to a television set that could switch itself off.
This is General Electric's new automatic television. It has an electronic memory that turns the set on and off at the exact time you wish without your having to raise a finger. You see? Automatically keeps you from missing your favorite programs. Now, the GE Ultravision picture is glare-free, unmatched in nationwide comparisons. Automatically, the set goes curfew to the children, like so. And this convenient clock always shows the correct time.
And GE TV is unmatched in value. Prices start at $99.95.
The jobbing actor you saw just being switched off in that energy-saving dream home earned a few bob between movies, urging Americans to wreck the ozone layer by switching everything on.
You know, good modern lighting makes a great deal of difference the way you live. This is an open court off our living room. Eye-catching, isn't it? Mine is pale blue. Very cool-looking. This, of course, is our living room. You know, Nancy, we'll see Patty later on.
Hello. It's rather interesting, too. See? Over the sofa and over each chair are individual lights built right into the ceiling. They do marvelous things for the room.
Around the edges of the room, set in the ceiling, are rows of fluorescents. They bathe the walls in light, make the room more alive and cheerful. And bigger, too. Notice?
Now, over here in the dining room, the mood's entirely different. See? Up there in the ceiling? Around the chandelier are a string of lights, 12 of them. Like a necklace of jewels.
Some are pink, some gold, some blue-white. When they're all on together, we have a white effect. By turning the knobs of this timber, you can change the colors, mix them, and get different effects.
You can have a warm yellow tone, or a more flattering pink, or a cool blue. I wish you could see the colors.
We can make the lights softer, or bring them up higher. Now I want to show you the most exciting thing.
Well, let's save the big surprise to last, shall we?
All right. Lighting helps us live better all over the house. Now, if this weren't a company night, we'd probably find Nancy in the bedroom.
Reading. And the light's just perfect for it. The correct distance up and behind. And look at this. A switch that controls the lights all over the house, inside and out. I press the button, they go on instantly.
Patty might be in her playroom. That's her doll, Cynthia, she's playing with. Notice the lights. They look like Japanese lanterns. They're just as colorful. Meanwhile, back in the den, Papa Reagan might be going over his script. And that's ideal, soft, over-the-shoulder light. So you see how modern light conditioning helps us have a more livable house.
You haven't forgotten the surprise, have you?
No, ma'am. We have a dimmer control for the living room, too. Watch when I turn it down.
Isn't it lovely? That's the view from our picture windows.
Well, those are some of the things we've done with lighting in our home. Might give you some ideas to help you see better and look better and live better in your home, to make your surroundings more colorful and cheerful.
We hope so, because we'd like everybody to find out how wonderful it is to live better electrically.
Rock on, Ronnie. No wonder Maggie loves them. They could flog British electricity boards back to us before we'd realize they're not even Maggie's to sell. Reagan can relax in his retirement, though, because there was one bit of Western propaganda that did take root behind the Iron Curtain. The Czechs have seized on Ron's shining example and have turned the simple art of switching on a light into a television drama, in which viewers at home can influence the plot. The story itself is fairly familiar, following the ups and downs, but mostly the downs, in the life of an itinerant chef. No names, no pectoral. As the plot thickens, a studio host offers the viewers the chance to vote for the different endings. And they can either whirl our hero into an argument about the right way to bone a side of beef.
Tohle je maso, který se včera uvařili a strčili do lednice. Dneska se ho vytáhli.
A to je dnešní maso.
Jo.
Or fling him into the arms of a kitchen maid. Meanwhile, members of the studio audience decide which way they want the plot to go by pressing the buttons on these Stone Age computers, while viewers at home do the next best thing. By clicking on and off their lights, viewers all over Happiness Grab draw surges of electricity from the state power plant, nudging its magnificent computer into life. The comrade chief engineer evaluates the readings, and back in the studio, the incompetent cook is given his cards. Shame we can't do that with the EastEnders. That Czech TV channel displays all the old world charm that some British stations showed 30 years ago. In the Channel Islands, where rich advertisers have always been a very finite resource, they never threw money away when it could be saved. Once upon a time, you could get four commercials for the price of one.
The Albion restaurant in Guernsey is open daily except Tuesdays for lunches and dinners at competitive prices. Selective wine list, continental cuisine. Phone Guernsey Central 3518. Use Vidal Motor Oil and get free £1,000 insurance if you own or operate commercial vehicles, etc. Leaflets and details from Chicks Motors, authorized Channel Island distributors of Vidal Motor Oils, Guernsey Central 3716. More and more motorists are fitting Trelleborg, the fabulous new Swedish tire with the longer life. Available in all sizes, from the smallest scooter to the largest tractor. Contact TAF Distributors, Jersey, for details. Meet your friends at the smart new rendezvous they're all talking about. The Hunter's Lodge at Jersey Point Hotel.
Sorry about that. Better, isn't it? Cheers. After the break, another aspect of energy conservation, keeping the likes of us alive and kicking. Meanwhile, here's how Frenchmen save money on their electricity bills, so they can spend it all on food.
Cette lampe, c'est moi, et ça marche à vie. Mais les légumes cuisinés, c'est Monsieur Bonduel. C'est nouveau. Plus vite. Ce sont des mélanges de petits légumes.
Ça, Monsieur Bonduel, j'aurais aimé l'inventer.
Wake up. Shower. Feed the cat. Breakfast. Kellogg's start. Get up to it any time.
Whether it's fluff under the sofa or fluffy on the sofa, with deep cleaning action and permanently attached tools, the Hoover TurboMaster can handle it.
see the arrival of Flight 642 from Luton.
Senor.
Me? Si. It's me parcel.
For everything you wash today, Parcel Automatic.
Honest.
Well, they've lived with me since they got wed, but now I'm pleased to say my daughter and my son-in-law are about to move away. At last, a place of their own. Now, they got their mortgage from the Leeds, because when it comes to your first home, you can trust the Leeds to give you help as well as give a loan, which could be up to 3.5 times your salary. Now, I got quite emotional on the day that they moved in. Tears of sadness for my girl and tears of joy for him. He'll be a big hit with the neighbours.
Leeds Mortgages. Special rates now available.
Senhores passageiros, bem-vindos a bordo. Atenção para estas instruções que parecem ajudar nesta viagem. Em suas relações sexuais, qualquer que seja o seu, e se por alguma razão você tiver que tomar uma injeção, nunca use seringas e agulhas de outras pessoas. Tenha certeza de que a seringa saiu diretamente de uma embalagem original, esterilizada, descartável. Se precisar de uma transfusão de sangue por qualquer motivo, exija um teste anti-AIDS no sangue que você vai receber. Lembre-se, a AIDS mata, sem piedade. Não deixe que esta seja a última viagem de sua vida. AIDS.
How to survive your summer holiday if you're travelling south to Brazil. I don't think it's that funny, actually. I think this is quite serious. So shut up. Since 1986, when almost every country in the world put the fear of God into its population with warnings about AIDS, gentle advertising campaigns have come along to persuade people, like you, that in this war, it's not all careless talk that can cost lives. A careless glance can do it too. British train charging into a Scandinavian tunnel, sheathed in a pink condom, is, I would have thought, a matter for Interpol. However, Norwegians didn't steal that 200-ton locomotive. They simply bought the film to illustrate that in tunnels, condoms can save lives. They could also garage a couple of Volvo estates too, I should think. Anyway, more modest Danish gentlemen settle for the regular size of condom, which, in Denmark, they can pick up while they tank up.
Yeah, what's up? Can you hear me?
Yep, Torber. Bit of toner, Torber.
Det er ikke mine.
Det må det være, for jeg har mine her.
That Rubber Johnny caption, by the way, was put on by the Danes, who are leading the way in trying to amuse us while trying to educate us. But even some unshockable Danes were surprised when they switched over to the Benny Hill show to discover they weren't watching Benny Hill at all. If you are watching Mrs. Whitehouse, phone Denmark, not me. Now, there's another massive threat to human existence on the loose at the moment, but the last thing advertisers want to do in this case is to turn the warnings about it into a joke.
1 gram of cocaine costs as much as a boombox. 2 grams of cocaine costs as much as a TV. 7 grams, a trip to Paris. 1 gram a week for a year, a new car. If you're on coke, everything you work for is disappearing. Right under your nose.
I do coke, so I can work longer. So I can earn more. So I can do more coke. So I can work longer. So I can earn more. So I can do more coke. So I can work longer. So I can earn more. So I can do more.
Always chasing rainbows.
You see, things don't go better with coke. A clever commercial warning smart grown-ups that they may not be so smart after all. But that guy was lucky. At least he'd grown up and got himself a good job. These American kids will be lucky to survive beyond the playground gates.
Now, kid, all you gotta do is be cool. You just give the stuff to your best buddies. You take it to a party. Tell your friends it's a great high. They should just try it. Tell them you can't hurt them.
I can do that.
Yeah, it's easy. Those kids are gonna be a pushover. Because they like you. You're a hot shot, right? They'll love you for it.
So how much do I charge?
Right now, nothing.
Nothing?
Just give it away. Let him have a free taste. Then you watch. You watch and you see who comes back for more.
And then I start charging.
You're a smart kid. You have a good day at school, Billy boy.
Some American kids don't even need to step outside the family to meet disaster. Everything they need is laid on for them at home.
It's yours?
No, I...
Your mother said she found it in your closet.
I don't know, one of the guys must...
Must have what?
Look, Dad, it's
Where
not...
Where did you get it?
Dad,
answer me. Who taught you how to do this stuff?
You, all right? I learned it by watching you.
Parents who use drugs have children who use drugs.
American parents who don't use drugs, the vast majority, were alarmed to see that last commercial. And those who attempted to feel smug about it were even more alarmed when this one came along.
Lies beget lies.
God, you sound like mother.
Well, she happens to be right. Lying is a vicious circle and there's no way out except to tell the truth.
One out of every five people who try cocaine get hooked. But that's not your problem. Or is it?
That coke-snorting bus driver was shown on American screens after a similar hard-hitting commercial was banned. Not even American nerves were strong enough to accept the sight of this chap snorting a line of coke before jumping into the pilot's seat of a jumbo jet. Once upon a time, children were allowed to grow up at their own pace, and in my day, taking 20 years to become an adult was regarded as normal. Today, promoters of pop music show children how to grow up in just 3 minutes. Which is where we came in. How did they do it? Well, the room stands still while the camera and the backcloth repeatedly pan past it. Maybe you spotted the joins down here as the doors opened and closed. The actual quality of the picture was far better than one we just saw. It was made to show the quality of the new high-definition TV system, which should be with us within the next 4 or 5 years. Next week, why old people are running scared of their children. But we leave you this week with a look back to the golden days when what you saw on the screen was what you got.
Thank you.